This is the project we're going to do today. I'm calling this one Tumbled Waters. I've got a sheet of chrome coat glossy cardstock here that is cut 5 to 7, and I'm pre-positioned most of my major stamps in my Stampin' Up! Stamping platform. So I'm going to start by stamping the side-facing waterfall. And I just have a ruler here that I'm using to offset the paper. And then I will stamp the waterfall with Memento Tuxedo Black ink. Okay, next we'll stamp the other waterfall that's next to it. And this time I'm just going to butt the paper up in the corner of the platform. And I'm also going to put just a little bit of a mask here. Okay, now I will stamp the trees that are on the left-hand side. And this time I'm going to use my Misty Creative Corners to offset the page. And next I'm going to stamp the trees that are on the right hand side, and this time I'm just going to put my ruler along the bottom. Okay, I thought I was recording when I added these little trees back here, but apparently I wasn't. So I had just taken this particular stamp here and I masked off either side like this, and I stamped it. And so that's how I got these trees. I didn't like the open V. It made everything look a little bit too symmetrical. Okay, now I'm going to give this a chance to dry really well before I start to color it, and we'll be back. Okay, I'm going to first color with some Copic markers. The ink I intend to put down, when I know I'm going to use my Copic markers, I generally like to use Memento inks because I know those work well with Copic markers. But I'm going to try some of my Altenew ink today, which I've never tried before on glossy cardstock, and so I don't know how that will play with Copic markers. So I want to put my Copic marker coloring down first. So I'll start by coloring the trees. I'm going to use G40, G43, and G46. Okay, and I want to make these trees next to these ones in the background a little darker, so I'm going to use a G99. Okay, now I'm going to take a paper towel and just kind of buff everything down. Okay, for the rocks, I'm going to use E55 and E57. And where I want to highlight the grass also, I'll go back in and highlight the grass. Okay, for the sky and the water, I'm going to use some of my Altenew ink cubes. You can buy these in sets, and the ones I'm going to use is called the Glacier Caves sets, and they're the color Arctic, Caribbean Sky, Purian Blue, and Sapphire. And so I'll start with the lightest color, which is the Arctic. And we will just start placing this onto the scene. Okay, next we'll do Caribbean Sky. Okay, and the next, the Persian Blue. Okay, now I'll use my long skinny brush to start adding the darker color into the darker areas of the waterfall. Okay, and now we'll do the darkest, which is Sapphire. And what I actually had to do with the sapphire color is after I put the color onto the brush, I patted it off on a paper towel before I started applying it to the page because the color was just way too intense to put directly on from the brush. Okay, the darkest color of this set, I think, is probably a bit too dark. Now I'm going to go back to the very lightest, and I'm going to take a clean brush to make sure that I don't have any of the darker ink on here. And I'm just going to go back and forth to try and blend that darker color back in as good as I can. Okay, I'm going to go back in now and I'm going to restamp these bottom trees here. Okay, I don't know how this is going to work, but I am going to use my stylus tools and some Dr. Martin's Bleedproof White. And I am going to see if I can just paint some of this onto the white areas. Let's see, this is going on too thick, so what I'm going to do is I'll put some in a different container here. And I will wet it down. And I will just wet this down with some water. And dilute it out a bit. Okay, and I'll try putting on the diluted one. And I want to make sure I'm using my smallest ball tip. So what I would do here is I would paint it on and then I would dab it with a paper towel, which would tend to soften it a bit. And then I'm also going to change over to the larger ball when I want to color in more area. And now I'm just making the rapids or whatever it is when the waterfall hits the lake to try and show the spray as the waterfall is hitting bottom. Okay, now I'm gonna give all this a chance to dry and we'll be back. Okay, now I'm also gonna use some Hero Arts Unicorn White ink because I want to soften some of these areas. And so I'm gonna use a cotton swab and I will just okay, now I'll use a white gel pen to add some more highlights. And I think I'll stamp the little kayaker into the water. I'm going to use some VersaFine Black Onyx ink and I'm going to use my stamp positioner because I'm going to want to get it positioned just exactly right. So let's see, maybe about right here. Okay, and I'm debating whether or not I want to stamp something in the foreground here. I kind of like this open like that, but I also have the option of maybe just putting a few little trees in here. And I hope I don't regret it. I'll use my Memento. Actually, what I'm going to do is I will just stamp it on a plate here to see how I like it. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to put anything in here. I'm going to just leave that open because I like it the way it is. Okay, so I think for all intents and purposes, this is done. I think I may put some birds up into the sky just by drawing with my pen. I sometimes just like to have some birds up there. And I will sign and date it. And I want to add some white gel pen highlights to the kayaker. Okay, I think the pigment ink is pretty well dry, and so I'm going to take it out and spray it with some Krylon UV resistant clear acrylic coating. And when I'm finished, we'll be back. And here is the final result, and I hope you've enjoyed this video. Bye!